Okay, so today I'm going to be demonstrating a few of the skills from the advanced sidemount course. But they require a little bit of explanation here on the surface before I demonstrate them in the water so you understand exactly what's happening. So first of all, let me introduce you to the regulator of death. And this rather sinister name has a good reason, and that's because this regulator has been deliberately set up with a number of failures so that we can actually work on dealing with those failures while we're in the water. So first of all, the regulator has been adjusted, obviously, so that it's free flowing continuously. One of the skills that I'm going to be demonstrating underwater is breathing from a free flowing regulator by feathering the tank valve. So as such. And the idea is to prevent the regulator from free flowing continuously, so you're not wasting your gas, but obviously still be able to breathe effectively from it. Now, another thing with the regulator is that there's actually, although you probably can't see it, but there's a hole in the mouthpiece. The mouthpiece actually detaches from the second stage, and there's also a hole in the diaphragm as well, which means that as well as breathing from a free flowing regulator, you're really having to concentrate on airway management, using the tongue as a splash guard, making sure that you're actually being able to breathe without choking, because this is a very wet breathing regulator. In addition, during the skills, we're going to remove the second stage completely, and I'm going to demonstrate breathing from the hose with the second stage removed, from the low pressure hose with the second stage removed. Again, by feathering the tank valve. Okay, so again, it means that you have to have careful control of the tank valve to make sure that you're not blasting the air too hard, and we're not wasting any air either, so we're constantly turning the tank valve on and off. The other thing I'm going to demonstrate is breathing directly from the tank valve itself with no regulator on there whatsoever. So I'm actually going to remove the regulator underwater, and then by again opening and closing the tank valve, demonstrate breathing from that while making the best use of whatever gas is remaining in that tank valve if you had a failed regulator that you couldn't get to work any other way and you had to remove it. The other skill I'm going to demonstrate is actually removing a regulator from one tank and switching it to another tank underwater while either breathing directly from the tank valve or breathing from the free flowing regulator. Okay, so that's what we're going to be doing today. We're going to head to the water now.